At the Dalí Museum, we take Salvador Dalí's own interest in science and technology to revolutionize the museum experience. To make his paintings, Dalí invented a way of waking himself from his dreams and then drawing what had passed through his mind. We wondered, how can we give people direct access to their dreams like this? Wouldn't that be inspiring?
The Dream Tapestry is a new interactive experience that creates fine art pieces from the museum visitors' dreams. To be able to do that, we brought OpenAI's Dali to the Dalí Museum.
Dali is an artificial intelligence model that takes text and turns it into an image. And these images are not images that have ever existed before. The Dream Tapestry is the first Dali-enabled exhibit in a museum, and we're so excited about it because it's going to be a debut of how Dali can really enhance all types of people's creativity.
The Dream Tapestry's artificial intelligence has a stylistic learning and understanding. So when we create each dream painting, we are doing so based on a selection of art styles.
A dream painting is a representation of your dream that you're going to create using AI. The dream painting is shown here on one of the easels. And the Dream Tapestry combines six different dream paintings together to create one big seamless representation of our dreams. What's really special about it is that the Dream Tapestry not only visualizes a remembered or imagined dream in a particular artistic style, it joins the dreams of six different visitors together. And it can give us a collective image of what we're dreaming as a country at that particular moment in time.
We give each visitor a sense of increased empowerment as though they had touched something essential and new in their life.
Hello, welcome to the Best in Heritage 2024. My name's Katey Goodwin and I'm Deputy Chief Executive of Art UK. And I'm delighted to be talking with Hank Hine from the Dalí Museum in the United States about the award-winning project, The Dream Tapestry, a collective canvas of dreams, which won a Webby Award in 2023. So hello, Hank, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi, Katey. It's a pleasure to be with you. Yes, I'm Hank Hine. I'm the director of the Dalí Museum in St. Petersburg, Florida.
Wonderful. So can you describe this award-winning project to us?
Yes. Well, the Dream Tapestry essentially was a machine experience to transform our visitors' dreams into art. It was an astounding project because dreams are such an important part of our self-identity in our world, and yet they're sequestered, they're hidden, and they're fleeting and ephemeral, and they zip through our unconscious minds and then are gone. And we wanted to give our visitors a way to bring this alive and make it tangible, something they could refer back to.
That's fantastic. Yeah, they definitely are fleeting. Sometimes you can remember them in the morning and they stay with you for ages, and then sometimes they're gone. It's an amazing way to try and capture that in an experience.
Yeah. Well, Dalí had his own way of capturing dreams. He used to take naps and start taking the nap holding a set of keys in his hands. And then as the keys would fall to the floor, he would wake up and draw the images he was seeing as he fell asleep.
That's really interesting.
It's difficult to do that in a gallery situation, though.
Yeah, I can see why you developed it in a completely different way. Yeah, that would be very, very tricky to do. So what was the history of this award-winning project? How did it come into being and what were its aims?
Okay, well, I think the aim was to bring the visitor in touch with the visitor's inner life, but also to share a kind of communal experience. Our history with AI goes back to 2016, we were the first museum in the world that we're aware of to use AI. We created a way of entering into one of Dali's paintings and navigating your way through it. And so we've been at the forefront of using technology, but always to connect the visitor, the experience of art is what we're after. This was a unique one. We wanted, we had an exhibition that I curated called The Shape of Dreams. It was a five-century survey of the ways that dreams had been depicted in paintings. And we worked with our ad agency and some other amazing thinkers, and were the first to work with OpenAI and use their program called Dali, which turns image text into image. And so that was our breakthrough to find a way to do this. So we had people describe their dreams, and then we trained the machine learning on the styles of the paintings in our exhibition, so that the painting that was created from the dream would be an extension of the exhibition. And then we went one step further. We gathered the dreams of a group of people as they were having this experience and created a tapestry of their dreams. And that probably was the greatest takeaway from for our visitors. The greatest pleasure was to share their dreams with others and to be part of something, taking something so private and so sequestered usually in our inner lives into a social engagement with others. So we had families, we had a sports team that came and shared their dreams. And that was a big takeaway.
That's fantastic. And what do you think were the particular qualities or innovations of the project that impressed the Webby Award judges?
Well, I think that being first in an area was impressive to them, but it was also done with great grace. The images were compelling and beautiful because they were trained on Odilon Redon's paintings and Karachi's paintings of St. Catherine and of Alexandria, and gorgeous fundamental works. And to see your dream expressed in these manners, I think, was very compelling to the judges. And I think the human interface, the sense of that we're not here alone, we're with others, which is the great thing of a museum experience. It's private to the extent that we're having our own personal reactions, but it's also public because we're having these intense experiences among others. So we created a way that what could have been insular and private, you know, the way digital technology is, sometimes we do things alone because of this. See movies on our phones instead of in a public theater. This was a way of creating community, and I think that was impressive.
Brilliant. That sounds really, really great. And how long did it take to develop the AI technology needed to deliver this experience? Was it a complicated process?
Well, I have been thinking for a long time on how we might bring people closer to their own dreams. And started putting together this collection of paintings. And it just happened that OpenAI, the company, produced its text-to-image technology just at that time. And also the coincidence that they had named the technology Dali. So we were able to engage their interest in letting us be first to use it.
And what feedback have you been gathering from visitors who've taken part in the experience? Are you evaluating their responses to see how the experience could be improved or developed?
Well, we have been improving it and created different styles, for instance, photographic styles, which are compelling to people also. But I think I have a couple of remarks from visitors. One said, the best part of my visit was having a conversation with other visitors about their dreams and taking a piece of their dream home with me. The dream tapestry is an unexpected way to connect with others, another said. I was in awe of this experience. I love seeing how my dreams manifested in artwork. So people loved what we hoped they would love, and we're still exploring how to refine the images and to create a learning experience about different styles of art as well.
That's brilliant. Yeah, some fantastic feedback there. And I can imagine it must be a wonderful thing to take part in and to connect with other people in that way. That's fantastic. And the images that created by the AI technology look wonderful. I had a look at those online. Are they stored somewhere or do they exist for a finite time as part of the experience?
They are ephemeral. They're gone. During the run of the exhibition, which was for 6 months, we compiled all the dreams and had them available on our website so that people could see other people's dreams.
That's wonderful. Yeah, that was going to ask that actually, is can people see the images being created if they weren't there in person? Yeah, I was able to see some of them on the website, but that's... if there is a way that people can have a look at them later, because it is really fascinating to see the sort of things that people were dreaming and then how they looked in the as images. Yeah, so that's
great.
Well,
a slimmer version of this, this was a huge station where multiple people could enter their dreams at the same time. Because our space is limited to museum, but we have kept it alive in one place and people can still visit and give a sense of their dreams through this process.
And are you developing any plans to create other innovative displays in the museum based around other aspects of Dalí's work?
It's really in our DNA and it comes from Dalí himself. You know, he was not only just innovative in general, but he embraced technology right from the start. You know, he made a film when he was 25 with Buñuel called Le Chien Andalou, the Andalusian dog. And he was the first to make an artist video, to use video. He worked in animation with Disney. He did sets for Hitchcock, you know, embracing new technologies, and even made holograms. So we knew that if he were alive today, he would be using the technologies that create this verisimilitude he was so interested in. So we get it. It's in our DNA. It's from Dalí, and we're doing more and many new things. For instance, last week we just opened a new exhibition, which is called Ask Dalí, in which we've trained our machine learning on all of Dalí's writings and using a different kind of AI program. We've made a kind of a simulacrum of his voice. And so you pick up a telephone and ask him a question, and it gives an answer in his unique kind of syntax and accent and the compendium of all the wide metaphysical things he loved to embrace and speak about. So you really get a very interesting answer.
Wow, that's amazing. Is it a lobster telephone that you can pick up and talk to him?
Yeah. It's not a reproduction of the one that we actually have that he made, but we kind of cribbed together, a plastic lobster just as a reference rather than an imitation.
I see. No, that's a really good idea. I can't imagine many, there's bound to be maybe a few artists that you could do that sort of thing with, but with him having such a distinctive style and perhaps with him have left behind such a body of work and all the writing as well, there's probably not many other artists around the world that you could do something quite so in depth with. So it's great that you're exploring just so many different aspects of his life.
Yeah. You're so right. We're fortunate to have him because he is the lead for this, for sure.
No, that's absolutely fascinating. Is there anything else you wanted to tell us about this particular project, or before we sign off?
Well, I think that, you know, that we have to look at AI both with caution, because I think it can be disruptive to, you know, the fabric of our general lives. But we also have to embrace it as a tool and have fun with it, because as every great artist has always done, used technology to amplify the human spirit and to create new and wonderful things.
Yeah, that's a really great way of looking at it. Thank you. Well, thanks ever so much for talking with me today, Hank. It's been really great to hear about your award-winning project and the work that you do at the Dalí Museum. So thank you very much.
Katey, it's been such a pleasure. Thank you.